initially it was meant to chase away the monkeys, because the monkeys are a menace on in our school. They make a lot of noise, they spoil a lot of things, and they disrupt academics. So that was our problem as a school. We came up with it. But from the input and the critique of our colleagues, we decided to advance it, to modify it, and now it's no longer just limited to chasing monkeys. It is now chasing all the pests on the farm and in the home. And it's now called an automatic scarecrow. And I said, Mr. Gutu Christopher, but this is a project for the school, and we are three of us. I just want to acknowledge my colleagues, Mr. Mugeni Crispinas, and Mr. Mahulo Gadin. And in the working, we had set in such a way that it should be, when you set it on, it should be on, but on standby mode, waiting to detect any animal, like a monkey, like the birds on the farm, it can also be borrowed by our brothers who live along the wildlife. To solve that problem of wildlife-human life conflict, instead of killing the wildlife, which will hamper our sustainable education for sustainability, because our future generation want to see those antelopes and elephants, we want just to scare them to go back to the bush, not killing them. Even the birds, we don't want to kill them using the insecticides and the pesticides, because those chemicals, you can, as you are aware, they also have another side effect. They are causing, there's a lot of cancer right now because of a lot of chemicals being used. So ours is environmentally friendly, and it is also sustainable. Once it senses the animal, it starts moving, barking as it flaps, scaring the monkey. That is the barking sound, mimicking the dog, which will scare the monkey, not killing the monkey.